With Appian's Case Management Studio, you can build case management style applications for any use case with easy-to-use configurations. If you're new to case management, this video will help you get started building a case type, start to finish. This video walkthrough is part of the Academy online course, Build with Case Management Studio, walkthrough and tutorial. Enroll in the course to get the tutorial so you can follow along and build it yourself. And you can try Case Management Studio for free at trial.appian.community. First, let's take a look at Workspace. This is where caseworkers will do their day-to-day work. They can submit new cases and review cases, tasks, and deadlines. To submit a new case, they'll fill out an intake form, first with general information for any case, then specific details about that case type. In a case's details, they can review progress, review and upload documents, and collaborate with teammates in comments. They can also access all tasks for the case and complete them so the workflow can continue. Now, I'll walk through the steps for building a case type using an internal benefits management example. To configure cases and workflows, go to Case Management Studio, which you can access from the navigation menu. To start, you can see all of the categories that cases can fall under and the case types within those categories. To start building, I'll first create a new category. I'll name it Employee Services and enter a description. Optionally, you can upload an image to display as the category header. Before I create a case type, I'll click into the category and go to the data page. Here, you can add custom fields to be captured for all cases and cases just in this category. I'll add a few of my own custom fields for the Employee Services category. First, I'll add department and choose short text as the type. Next, I'll add a field for office location. To allow users to choose their office from a dropdown, choose choice list as the type, then add the list options on separate lines. Next, I'll create a new case type within this category. I'll return to the details page and click Create Case Type. I'll give it a name, Benefits Management, a prefix based on that name, BM, and a description. The default SLA, or Service Level Agreement, is the number of business days it is expected to complete the case. I'll say 10 days. For default priority, medium. Next is the default assigned group. Select the human resources group, so users in this group will be assigned the benefits management cases. If in practice you need to use a group that doesn't already exist, work with a developer. After clicking Create, I'll open the new case type. To start configuring it, I'll go to the data page to add a few data fields specific to benefits management cases. A choice list for the benefits type, and a date field for the requested effective date. Next, it's time to customize the intake form. Remember when I created a new case, the first page captured some basic information about all cases. Now, I'll create the rest of the form that is unique to this case type. I'll start by renaming the title to Request Details. You can add input, selection, and display fields by simply dragging them from the left. Let's start with the benefits type choice list. Because this is a choice list, under Selection, I'll drag in a dropdown. Then, I need to go to the right pane to configure it. First, I need to choose which field the input should be saved in. Under Store To, click Select Data Field. Then, I'll choose the benefits type field I just created. You'll see that the label automatically updates based on the field I selected. I'll make this required in the form by selecting the checkbox. When I click the dropdown, I can see the choices I entered earlier when I created the field. The next field to add is the requested effective date. For Stored To, I'll select Requested Effective Date and add some instruction text so the purpose of the field is clear. And I'll add a validation to ensure the due date is today or later. Under Criteria, select On or After Today. I'll quickly test it out by trying to select yesterday's date. I'll add another page for the personal information about the requester. In the same way, I'll add fields for the office location and department. Now, I'll go to the workflow page to configure the tasks that need to be completed. In this tutorial, I will create all new tasks, but you can also reuse tasks and task blocks that have already been created. First, I'll create a task to review the case submission. I'll add a name and description, then give it an SLA of 2 days. For the default assigned group, I'll use the Human Resources group again. Keep in mind that, in practice, you'll likely assign different tasks in the workflow to different groups. Under Task Type, there's a dropdown for the 3 types of tasks: Confirmation, Decision, and Documents Upload. I'll select Confirmation because the caseworker will confirm that they completed the intake review. I also need to add a decision task to direct the workflow in different ways based on whether the external benefits system needs to be updated. When a decision type is selected, a few more configurations appear. First, I'll enter a question that the caseworker will answer, and then enter the response options. I'll create a few more tasks I need to follow up with the requester and close the case. Next, I'll click Add to include them in my workflow. Then, I'll configure the tasks to organize the workflow. First, caseworkers will review the request, and this will lead into 2 tasks that can occur at the same time. You'll assign tasks as dependents to arrange their order. First, I'll add the review as a dependent of the start, then these other 2 tasks as dependents to the intake review. Next, let's look at the updates required task. Because this is a decision task, the 2 responses will lead in different directions. If updates are required, the workflow will go to the benefit system updated task. If updates are not required, the workflow should go to the request resolve task. I also need to clear this checkbox so the request resolve task appearing is not dependent on this task getting resolved first. I'll configure a few more tasks, then we'll go to the request resolve task. Let's say I want the request resolve decision to return to an earlier part of the workflow if the request has not been resolved. To do so, add 2 dependents with no responses that lead into 2 earlier tasks. You also need to uncheck the resolution required checkbox so the tasks appear when needed. Now that my tasks are in order, it's time to add some milestones to organize them. Under Milestone, click the Edit button and add Creation, Fulfillment, Resolution. Then, set them to the appropriate tasks. Now, the workflow is done and the tasks will be assigned to the right group at the right time. Keep in mind that you can collaborate with developers to automate parts of your workflow. For example, you could involve a developer to automate updating the external benefit system so you don't have to do it manually. Finally, I'll go to the summary page. Here, you can configure which fields are displayed on the summary page and which fields a caseworker can edit. Under Display Data, I'll click Add Data Fields. Then, I'll add each of the custom fields that I created. You can also change how the names are displayed, but I'll stick to the default. For the edit form, I'll reuse the intake form by clicking Copy Existing Form. As is, this will allow caseworkers to edit anything. But keep in mind that you can remove or add any fields depending on your needs. And now, my case type is done. To test it out, I'll go back to Workspace. Here, I'll click Submit Case to open the intake form. Remember, this first page is collected for all case types by default. I can also upload a supporting document. After I fill out the rest of the form, I'll open the case and see the summary page with the information, details, tasks, and milestones. I'll click the 3 dots next to the review request task to complete it, and leave any comments and upload supporting documents. Now I see the next 2 tasks in the workflow. Throughout the workflow, I am also receiving email notifications about the case, such as when I'm assigned a case or a task. And that's all. In a few minutes, I just built an entire workflow for managing benefits requests. This example will help you get started with Case Management Studio. But don't forget that you should partner with developers to build workflows with automated tasks, forms with complex data validations, and to follow processes for testing and deployment.